Hello, this is H.C. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! Let's continue through the Lunar Subterrane. Someone was asking me, H.C. Bailey, do the elemental resistances of the dragon equipment stack? And the answer is no, you only need one piece of dragon equipment for that effect. Against a new enemy like this! Okay, first things first. Switch Rose. Go, Edward, go! This guy is weak to fire and holy. Okay, actually, Yang has a holy elemental weapon with the God Hand there, so I'm not even worried about that. Yeah, not a good idea being weak to holy in this area. The DS version, much bigger problem. And here's another new enemy, Gold Dragons. I think Edward can still one-shot them. Or maybe not. Okay. Or, oh yeah, that's right. He has the white tiger mask that makes him immune to paralysis. One thing you gotta be careful for with this guy is that he can use Thunder Attack on your party, which takes off half your HP, unless you have, like, diamond armlets or some lightning resistance, which is why I have them. And every time you attack the guy, he'll counterattack with that paralysis effect. So you gotta watch out for that. By the way, the dragon equipment also, well, resists dragon damage. So whenever a dragon, like, physically attacks you, you will take a lot less damage. Same thing for the gold hairpin. Uh-oh. Monsters! With a behemoth. Let's see how challenging he is this time around. Well, I'm not gonna have it. Actually, Edward, hide. Edward, you're not gonna be too useful in this fight. Now, I could... You know what? Let's have him do that. Let's have him use the box wine. There we go. Like, as before, you want to be careful for his counterattacks. Whenever you attack him, he'll counterattack you. Unfortunately, I only have one blink user this time around instead of three like the last time. But, oh well. You want to make sure that your frontline characters have blink if you can. Otherwise, just keep on going with focus. Use your most powerful attacks. Do not use magic on him. Do not. Rosa, there you go. Well, actually, we probably don't need blink now. We've almost got the guy. I think he has, like, what, 23,000 HP? Yeah, not that much. And for defeating him, we get the Stardust Rod, the ultimate rod for Ridia. Not that I'm... Well, obviously, I'm not going to use it. I suppose Palin could equip it, but... I like keeping him on his unique weapon. I went through all that effort to get it. Gotta keep it around. How do we get to those other ledges? Remember that for later. But anyway, here, we got another new enemy, Ahriman. Okay, good. Let's use focus on him, because he's got a lot of HP. Now, this guy, as well as other enemies, is one of... I didn't want to do that. One of the big reasons why I brought Palum around, but now I'm probably not going to get to show it off. Oh, well. But anyway, yeah, this is another one of the reasons why I've dropped the battle speed so much. Now, basically, all Ahriman does is use that doom death effect, whatever it is. So, the reason I brought Palum along, one of the big reasons, is because of Flare! Yeah! Because Ridia does not learn that until level 55. Palum learns that a lot sooner. Okay, three levels sooner. But still, that's a lot. So, and really, I don't care for her summons, at least for most of the bosses here. Uh-oh. We got new enemies, Blue Dragon and Red Dragons. Let's see. Okay. Just thinking about what I want to do. Red Dragons are weak to ice! Both of them are resistant to fire. So, yeah, Edward, well, he can still get a lot of good stuff done. But, whoa. Can someone heal Edward, please? Get your turn before he hides. Nuts. But anyway, Blue Dragons are also resistant to holy. Nuts. Well, so much for you, Edward. But we want to kill the Blue Dragon first. But yeah, since the Blue Dragons are resistant to holy, obviously Cecil isn't going to deal as much damage to him. Yang isn't with the God Hand, But you could use the second pair of cat claws that I brought along with me. Obviously, I could use Blazaga on the red dragon, but since Yang can also exploit that weakness, I figured let's have Palom use Flare on the blue dragon, and there we go. And we get the crystal shield from him. All right. Let's do that. Yeah, that's better. Pretty much better in every way. Just like Cecil's paladin equipment, it boosts your spirit by 3. Or is it 5? 5. 3, sir! One of the really nice things about Flare, it's instant cast. So basically, it's pretty much just like, what is that one? Bio, but stronger. There we get the Protect Ring, which we absolutely want to give to Edward there, because he could use as much help as he can get. Especially with his, his HP's not doing so bad anymore. He's finally starting to get some HP growth. Let's head down first. Let me guess, monsters. Alright, that was a behemoth there, and for defeating him, we get the Crystal Mail. But I don't want to equip that on Cecil, because, well, I'll show you. It resists all status ailments, which includes Berserk. And I like being able to Berserk Cecil for certain battles, so we're going to leave that alone for now. But just something to keep in mind. There's also ribbons that do the same thing. Oh, as if that's a spoiler. It's a Final Fantasy game. Of course there's ribbons that resist all status ailments. Alright, for defeating them, we got the Crystal Gloves. Those were 2 red dragons there. Holy cow, they kicked my ass. But anyway, yeah, we'll give those to Cecil there. The various equipment, crystal equipment that you can get for Cecil has, like, some different effects, like resisting undead or something other like that. I really don't care about that. All I care about is the raw defense for the most part. The status resistance will be nice eventually, but not right now. And in this chest... Oh, okay. I was being prepared for monsters, but I guess I was wrong. There we get the white robe for Rosa. See, we got the 74 spirit. The luminous robe gives plus 5 already. Now we got 84 spirit, so plus 15 spirit for her. That's pretty nice. Here we got another new enemy, Little Murderer. They are weak to lightning, as you'll find out. But I will tell you, do not use lightning on them. Do not. You want to see what happens when you cast lightning on them? Watch the first LP. You will see what happens. Ha! I'm not going to do that here because I don't have access to save states. So, but fortunately, I don't think Yang's lightning claws are affected by that. I'll just tell you, if you use lightning on him, he's like, ha ha, I tricked you, and starts casting thunderbolt or lightning or whatever on your party over and over and over again with massive damage. I mean, you will not survive for very long that way. So, yeah, do not do that. There's a reason why it was called a trickster in the Super Nintendo version of the game. Alright, that was a battle with a Dark Sage and a Dino Zombie, and for defeating them, we get the Crystal Helm for Cecil there. So, there we go. Keep the Dragon Mail on Cecil, though, for the... Well, actually, the Crystal Helm gives him all the elemental resistances, but... Well, you know what? I don't think I'm going to run into a Behemoth or Behemoth in the near future, so let's use that for now. And heal up after that one. That was not very nice of those guys. Got the dragon whisker. That's a whip for Iridia. I just won that from a blue dragon there. Holy cow. That might actually be pretty useful for her. I haven't won one of those in quite a while. Man, I'm getting pretty damn lucky with these rare drops. There's nothing to the right there. Not in this game. In this chest, we get a Red Fang. Now, there is a particular rare enemy that you can meet up with here with a Siren. I'm going to save that for later. Not today. Don't worry, viewers. I will show them off. Just not today. We'll save that for another day. It is a rather long battle if you want to actually win it. There we can start getting the ultimate shurikens in the game for Edge, if you brought them along. More Artemis arrows, alright. Never have enough of those. I think that's all the ones that you can find. The only way you can get more is by stealing them from Moon Maidens. Uh-oh. Looks like a dead end. Hi-yo! Unless you go across an invisible bridge. Yeah, no way you can figure that one out. But I know where they all are. Ooh, and a golden apple. You know, I might want to save that for Rydia. Let's keep an eye on that. I'll save it for later. Yeah, Edward's stat growth in the higher levels is really, really, really good. He just skyrockets late game. That's why he's doing so good right now, or one of the reasons. Alright, that was just another battle with a behemoth, and for defeating him, we get another Protect Ring. That one I want to give to Yang. I like giving them to my frontline characters, because they could use all the defensive help they can get. So, Rosa, not so worried about in the back row there. Alright, looks like we finally made it. But can we defeat Bahamut's evil twin? How about death itself? Do I have it in me to brutally murder some innocent princesses? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! This is H.G. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!